Well, good morning. This is Tina Frazier from Columbus, Ohio. I'm coming to you with a little bit of a diamond painting video this morning. It is Saturday. I don't know the date exactly, but it's about 10:50 in the morning, and I'm also kind of playing around with my new webcam, so it's a little closer, a little clearer. Sorry for any glare that you might see. I'm just trying to do this with the video camera kind of close. I'm holding it in my hand, actually. I need to get some way to, the whole reason why I bought this, my husband bought me this webcam, is so I can do diamond painting and cross stitch videos from above like this, paint with me and stitch with me videos. I don't normally have a way to do that, because the only camera that I have is on my laptop. So I just kind of wanted to show you this. This is my first diamond painting that I'm pretty close to finishing. This was from Huacan on AliExpress. I don't know if it's called Huacan, that's what everybody calls it, or a Huacan, or whatever, however it's pronounced. But I'm going to go ahead and show you, don't mind the shaking. Here is the company that it came from. And this is what I've got done so far. Don't mind the shaking. I don't know if this camera has a zoom feature on it or not, so this is the first time I'm using it, but this is what I've got done so far. That's the area that I'm working on this morning, and I still have this whole strip down here to do, all the way from the bottom. But the reason why I haven't yet is because this part here underneath the paper is still really sticky, and I just need to put washi tape on it before I expose it. So anyway, this is what I've got done. You can see I've gotten to the top up there already. I got her face done. Her face is just absolutely cute. But this is a 29 color. It's 45 by 60. I think this was the biggest size it came in, and here's what it's supposed to be when I'm finished. So you can see I've got a good majority of it completed. I really love this. This is a square drill, and it's full coverage. I really love this. There's three other colors you can get. There's my cat over there. She's like climbing. And I get to talk to you about that stack of magazines that she's standing on a little bit later in a stitching update video. But yeah, so I just decided to, on this kind of rainy, cool Saturday morning, to show you my diamond painting. And you may not know, but my father-in-law, you may know that we've been dealing with the loss of my mother-in-law on May 1st, and just some other stuff. Well, my father-in-law passed away Wednesday night, so yeah, we're kind of not expecting to go to West Virginia this weekend. We're just kind of taking it easy. Sunday, your easy weekend. We're going to go down next weekend. I have bereavement leave starting the 30th, so I'll be off for that week, so you may actually see more videos. But anyway, look how shiny these drills are, you guys. This is really shiny. I get a little close, and actually the symbols on this are really clear for the most part. I am using a light pad. I have a light pad back here. My husband actually ordered it because he wants to. Here's my light pad. My husband ordered it because he wants to do some drawing and tracing and stuff. And I was like, oh, you're ordering a light pad. I can use it for diamond painting. But yeah, so this is the first ever I have. I have two others on standby. I think I might have shown you these, but I have two others on standby. I have, you know, they're upside down, but anyway, I just show you the box. There's the box with the two diamond paintings in it. I'm still trying to figure out my recording setup for this, but anyway, I just figured I'd come to you with this. I'm hoping to do what Stitcherista did and get one of those sticky bead mats and stick it here so I can stick my trays to it. This is the zoom out. This thing that I have it on is just the same easel on my cross stitch floor stand that I have, and I'm using a desk, like a old Hello Kitty desk blotter, behind my light pad to give it a little more support. You can see the canvas is a little bigger, and this I can adjust to any angle and work on it. And it's just easier than sitting at a table and working on an easel or working on a flat table. So anyway, this is a little bit of a diamond painting. I don't know if I'm going to be able to sit and hold the camera. The camera's going to jerk around a lot. And the angle that the camera would sit on if I just put it on my tripod would be way over here. This would be the angle that you would see it at if I would have it just sitting on the tripod for you. This might not be a bad angle, but you're not going to be able to see where I'm placing the stuff that drills. So yeah. I have to figure out where to clip the video camera, but at least this way, and I can't turn it this way because, you know, then I'd have to turn my chair and the chair would just be in the way. So, I'm in my pajamas. I have Hello Kitty slumber time pajamas. It's really cute. I got this out of a Sanrio crate box, which is a subscription box that you can get. It comes out once a quarter. Has Hello Kitty stuff in it. It's like Loot Crate, if you're familiar with the subscription box Loot Crate. It's very similar to that. Comes out by the same company, but it's all Hello Kitty stuff, and it's really cute. But anyway, I just kind of wanted to show you guys that. A little bit later, I'll probably be doing an unboxing. Well, I've already unboxed the other two, but I'll be doing like kind of showing you the inventory and showing you one of the other ones as I opened up. Stitcherista, one of the other floss tubers, she's been into diamond painting lately, so she's been doing a lot of diamond painting. It's got a lot of dust on it. A couple of the other people have been using rainbow looms. I have rainbow loomed one of the pink. This is one of the pink diamond painting pens that you get pretty much in every kit. For some reason, when I first ordered these kits, I was like, oh man, I need more tools. So I ordered like a package of pink pens. So I ended up getting like 10 extra pink pens, and I got inspired watching somebody else. I have a rainbow loom, you know, with the rubber bands. I kind of got into that a couple years ago when they were really popular at Christmas time, and I have a bunch of rubber bands in the rainbow loom. So I decided that I'd make myself a multi-drill pen with the this is the 3-placer over here. And this is, I believe, the 10-placer, 9-placer, whatever that's called. I'd make myself a double-ended multi-placer pen and use my rainbow loom rubber bands and make a cover for it. I can do a video showing you that. But if you're curious, these are the rainbow loom bands that I used. They're pink, blue, and white. You can see the rainbow loom brands. This one, it's called Sweets Bonbons Cotton Candy. This one, this color is Sweets. Where is it? Sweets Bonbons and Cotton Candy. It's probably a little too dark. Sweet Bonbons and Cotton Candy. Anyway, so I have the drill pen, and then this is just the white pen that came with the Huacan. And it comes with the little rubbery thing. I may end up rainbow looming my white pen that I like. But yeah, this also has a three placer on the end. But and I'm using the round tip for my square drills. I'm not having any problems using round tip for the square drills. I know they make a square tip one, but yeah, I'm not using that. So I kind of started this right before Christmas. The three that I ordered, I was originally going to save for Christmas as a Christmas present last year, but my husband said just go ahead and pick one to work on, and then you know, you can wrap the other two for Christmas. So that's what I did, and this was the one that I started working on. I'm actually really liking diamond painting. It goes a lot quicker than cross stitch, that's for sure. But yeah, it I don't know, we'll see how many more I get. I only have three so far. There are a couple that I have my eye on that I've seen people working on, but yeah. So this is what I've got. Oh, and I'm also using the you can see in there in the tip here, I'm using the pink wax that comes with pretty much every diamond painting kit. Pink wax. It's not gonna focus, I'm sorry. But anyway, so this is my little quick diamond painting video for you. So yeah, once I get done with this, I'm actually going to show you the finished product, and then you know, also I will get into getting one of the other ones ready. I think I know the one I'm going to work on next. It's my Princess Mononoke one. Yeah, so I'm going to go ahead and get back to diamond painting, and we'll see where it goes. I'm going to go ahead and keep filming, so just, you know, kind of bear with me a little bit. I'm sorry you're not going to be able to much watch the film. I wish I knew of a way to zoom. I'll probably have to end up using a different software. Get down. My cat Charmander was kind of getting to me. So, bear with me. I have some drills in here. My little tray. There's some drills. This is color 500, which you all know DMC 500 is a green. It's kind of a dark forest green. So this is kind of where I'm at right now. I would turn the work over the other way, but if I turned it over, I'd be working way up there, and it's not very comfortable. My light board doesn't go up there, so I have to work on this way. It's why, one of the reasons why you won't get to see me really placing drills. Like I said, I have to work with the camera and figure out the best filming angle for this, but you get the idea. So basically what I do is I take my pen, I just tap it onto the drill, and you see the drill sticks. You can see it on the thing there. It's not very close up, and then I just place it on the corresponding color on the thing, and it sticks. It's a lot of fun. It's kind of monotonous. Oh, and I'm also currently watching KickinCancersButt, I think is who it is, on YouTube on my television. She does a lot of diamond painting and a lot of unboxing videos and stuff. And so I'm sitting here kind of watching her. I have it paused in the background so you can't hear it. I don't know what the thought is on having another YouTube channel playing in the background as you're recording your YouTube video. I don't know if that would get you banned or kicked out because you're kind of showing another person, or they can hear another person, or if you just turn it down super duper low so it's just like low background noise. I don't know if you're allowed to do that or not. If somebody out there could tell me if you're allowed to have somebody else playing in the background, that would, like, or somebody else's YouTube playing in the background. That would give me an idea for just being able to, do stitch with me videos to have a little more background noise than besides me talking or not talking. I know you can get free music out there. I have some free music, but I don't know. It would just. And sorry about that. You are hearing my husband snore. So he's still asleep. But yeah. If you think that's funny, well, there's your white noise for you. So anyway, just let me know what the thoughts are of having someone else's YouTube video playing in the background on lower volume, so there's noise back there, but you can't really hear it. I'm in the living room. We don't have a door on our bedroom doorway because we have six cats, and if we were to close the door at all, the cats would start scratching on the door. So we've taken the door off the hinges and we've put up a curtain. So the curtain, we can close the curtain when we have company, and the cats can still get in and out without us having to hear them scratch at the door whenever we want the door closed. It's been a lot easier for us that way. And that's why you can hear my husband in the bedroom snoring. And I'm sorry for that. All right, so this is about 16 minutes. I'm gonna go ahead and let me put in these last few. And, put in these last few and call it with this little video clip. Course, right when I get ready to start, to stop, he stops. All right, I think that's it for this color. This is 500. There is none over there. All right, so that's it for this video, you guys. Thank you for watching, and I'm gonna go ahead and cut the video, and we'll call it a day. Thanks a lot. Bye bye.